Hi, I'm Jeff Knutson from Common Sense. Pop quiz, what's your favorite type of formative assessment? I know, it's hard to choose. In terms of online formative assessment, there are a ton of options. A lot of them are fun for students, and they're a great way for teachers to check for understanding. But how do you pick the best one for your classroom? Let's check out two popular options, Kahoot and Formative. Both Formative and Kahoot make it easy for kids to respond to online quizzes and questions, and it's easy for teachers to get real-time data. For teachers, both platforms are web-based, but they'll work on any device. Neither requires student accounts, and, wait for it, they're both free. Either platform can be used across grade levels from elementary to high school, and they're both great for just about any subject. Students can respond with most any device, whether it's a computer, Chromebook, tablet, or even their own phone. But even though these two platforms work in similar ways, there are some key differences. Let's take a closer look. Kahoot basically upgrades a multiple choice quiz and uses it to turn your classroom into something like a game show. The lively, upbeat music and bright colors are sure to boost engagement, and students can see scores and rankings in real time. Teachers project questions and answer options onto a screen. All students need is the code to participate. They just type in their name to get started. After a quiz, teachers can view and download students' data for each question. And Kahoot also offers what's called ghost mode. This allows students to try and boost their scores by competing against others who've already taken the quiz, or even the ghosts of their former selves. Whoa! Also, teachers get access to tons of public Kahoots. You can use them as is, or even edit to make them your own. And you can customize quiz options to make them more or less competitive and game-like, depending on what's best for your classroom. Now, Kahoot can be a lot of fun, and your students might even love that catchy music. But if you're looking to give students more robust feedback, it's worth checking out Formative. With Formative, options for questions go beyond multiple choice, with short answer, drawing, or even images and videos. Students can respond with any web-enabled device by typing in the question code and their name. As supporting material, they can also show their work. Students don't need accounts to participate, but if they do log in, you can track their progress over time and share feedback and grades. Most importantly, students can get immediate feedback on the spot as they're answering questions. This is something you definitely can't do with Kahoot. Plus, Formative has some LMS-like features where students could even submit other classwork or assignments. So, which is the better choice? It really depends on what you're looking to achieve. If you're looking for a really fun, even competitive way to quiz your students, Kahoot is definitely the winner. The ghost mode is innovative, and you'll get data for each question, but it doesn't track progress over time. On the plus side, all of Kahoot's public, pre-made assessments are a bonus for busy teachers. Formative may not be as flashy, but it gives you more question options and the ability to track student data over time. The instant feedback can promote deeper learning. If that's what you're looking for, definitely go with Formative. Plus, the LMS-like features could be really handy. In the end, it might just come down to whether you favor more fun or better feedback. So, what kind of formative assessment is best for your classroom? Tell us what you think and check out all the best EdTech tools and lesson ideas at Common Sense Education.